It was a fire that brought tears to the community.
They could not make their way to the victims.
Now one family is coping with the loss of 5 family members.
3 children, their mother and grandmother, died. It was so preventable. There are no smoke alarms there in that house.
The greatest single factor in saving lives is having a working smoke detector in your home.
It just drove home that we needed to do something more.
Data from the American Community Survey allows us to focus more on prevention.
New Orleans is really a unique city.
Less than 400,000 people with very modest resources.
So it's a little bit different here. We have a lot of old areas. Houses are very close to each other. So if a fire gets a head start on us, it can easily jump from building to building to building. I would much rather put a smoke alarm in someone's house. If I never have to make another fatality, I'll be thrilled.
The New Orleans Fire Department had a fairly passive program, which required the resident to call the firehouse, and then a firefighter would come and install a smoke alarm free of charge. People didn't really take advantage of that program.
We had this idea of going out and canvassing, but you don't know what your success is going to be.
I reached out to Chief McConnell and asked how we could help.
It didn't really hit me at first how they would interact with us, but they came and they said, look, we want to talk to you about it and we think we can help.
We developed a model using American Community Survey data that identifies those census block groups most in need of smoke alarms.
Houses that were least likely to have a smoke alarm and most likely to have a fatality due to fire.
Then we looked at American Community Survey data on where we have concentrations of the very young and very old.
People who are most likely to die in a fire tend to be very young, under the age of 5, or older, you know, over the age of 60.
Poverty.
Someone struggling to, you know, put food on the table, they're probably not going to go out and put a smoke alarm in.
That data was contained in the American Community Survey, which is available at a very, very discreet level.
Having the data really allowed us to target the areas that were most likely to not have the smoke alarm and most likely to have a fatality from a fire.
So we were able to pinpoint those areas most at risk for fire deaths.
So we took it up a notch. Targeted those areas first, going door to door, boots on the ground, every single address.
Those smoke detectors and batteries in there are good for 10 years, yeah?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. You don't have to fool with them for 10 years.
Come on, man.
Yep.
We're gonna install one in your bedroom.
I need one in there.
Yeah.
Well, I have to get one.
Okay. No, we're gonna put one in for
free.
You know, we've had a smoke alarm program as far back as I can remember. But generally, we were under 1,800 smoke alarms a year. With this campaign, we did 10,000.
About 8 months later, there was a fire in one of the houses in that neighborhood.
When the firefighters got there, 11 people out front. We saved 11 in one fire.
Because of this very low-cost intervention. One of the big lessons from this project is that we were using data that was really all publicly available and free, like the American Community Survey.
And using census data like that allowed them to come up with a really good target area.
This model could really be generalizable nationally. Any community can identify which neighborhoods are most in need of smoke alarms. The American Community Survey is tremendously valuable to us and was really vital for this project.
If you can prevent one person from losing their life, it makes this program worthwhile.
Have a good day, sir.
Yes.